Hello, welcome back to Ecommerce Solutions. In our previous lesson, we talked about continuity of the function. And say that as far as continuity is concerned, you have continuity at a point and continuity within an interval. And that's we're talking about uniform continuity. Now, we actually said that when we have a function f of x, then we say that it is continuous at a point, say s limit. We want to say something like this. The limit of f of s as s approaches s limit is equal to the function value at that point. Then, as you know, this one has got its own equivalence statement. So given any epsilon positive, there exists delta. So when you look at our previous video, you realize that you have equivalence statement for this particular. And we made the point that we can use continuity at a point to prove that a function is uniformly continuous. Where the actual issue is that when it is possible that we select delta and it's not depending on x naught, then we say that particular function is continuous uniform. Let's pick an example of this. So let's look at an example one. We are showing that, so show that the function f of s equals 3s plus 7 is uniformly continuous on R, the set of real numbers. So we are showing that this particular function f of s equals 3s plus 7 is uniformly continuous on the set of real numbers. So let's see how we do that. So we are proving that the proof. So we begin by saying that let S naught, so we let S naught be a member of this set. So if S naught is a member of this set, then it is possible that for this function to be uniformly continuous, then first of all, it should be continuous at s naught. So the limit of this function, 3s plus 7, as x approaches x naught, should be equal to 3s naught plus 7. Now, there is something very important that we need to note. When a function is uniformly continuous, then it presupposes that it is continuous at a point. So if it is continuous within an interval, then it is continuous at every point within an interval. That's why we are starting the proof by saying that if we are to show that this is uniformly continuous on R, which means that it is continuous on the set of real numbers, then if X naught is a member of the set of real numbers, then it should be continuous at that point. So we will continue from there. Now if this is the case, then we will have the equivalent statement of this, which is that if we are given any epsilon, so given epsilon positive, there should be a certain delta, which is the function of epsilon greater than zero, such that any time we say x minus x naught, now we remember x minus whatever s is approaching, the average of this. Whatever we say this, then we mean that the absolute of the function, which is 3s plus 7 minus its limit. So this time 3s naught plus 7 should be less than epsilon. So this is what we mean. Anytime we say that x minus x naught, the absolute of this, anytime it's less than delta, the implication is that the absolute of the function minus its limit should be less than epsilon, where epsilon is a very small positive number. Right. So let's pick it from here. Our ability to show that the absolute of all this is less than epsilon means success for us as far as proving to see that this function is uniformly continuous on the set of real numbers is concerned. So let's pick it from here. So we have the absolute of 3s plus 7 n minus, so this becomes 3 s naught n minus 7. And this is the same as saying that A will give us 3 s. But this nullifies this one. We have 3 s naught n still in the aggregate. Now it's possible that we factor 3 out. See, when we're doing this, we are mindful of what we have here. We are always interested in getting something like x minus x naught, so that we can include this delta and that will lead us to epsilon. So we factor 3 out here. We have 3 out, then x minus x naught. Alright, so we have this. Good, so the 3 is already positive, so we can bring that out of the absolute symbol. And that will give us x minus x naught, the absolute symbol. When we reach here, then we begin to smile because what we are after, we have actually arrived at it. So we have x minus x naught. Absolute of it is less than delta. So it means that introducing delta here means whatever we have here is going to be less than 3 delta. Good. We need to select a value or something for delta that will lead us to epsilon. Now you agree with me that at this point there is no, we don't have any x naught here. So if I want to select delta such that to lead us to epsilon, then I'll go somewhere and hide, then quickly equate this one to epsilon. Then I'll make delta the subject. So delta here equals epsilon over 3. So we realize that the selection of epsilon here doesn't depend on x naught. So we have that in our mind. So we realize that by putting x delta here, we have everything here to do. Now 3 multiplied by epsilon over 3, which leads us to epsilon. So the more pressing point here is that our selection of delta doesn't depend on x naught. So we say that the function will conclude that therefore this function f of x equals 3x plus 7 is uniform continuous on R, the set of real numbers. Now it can also be said that once it is uniformly continuous on the set of real numbers, then it is also continuous in the set of variables. But what we have been able to show is that we are selecting delta and it's not depending on x naught. So we conclude that it is uniformly continuous on the set of variables. Thank you very much. These things are not difficult. If you still face challenges, you can subscribe to our channel and ask relevant questions and we'll be there to ask you next time by message. We'll look at another example as far as this concept is concerned. Thank you very much.